Hello everyone, this is Mar Haddad here. This is the first lab of the course of Legal Wave NFT, and in this lab I'm going to show you how you can connect your computer to the NFT device in order to configure it. Of course, when we want to make work on the NFT, we need to get connected to it in order to be able to do the configuration. So as you can see here, we have 4 points to do. It's a very small lab, but this is a very important lab because once you know how to connect to the NFT, then you are able to do the configuration. So let's go point by point and start doing the lab. Point number one, set an IP address on your PC to 192.168.2.1. So this is the first step I need you to do, but you need to put this IP address on the Ethernet interface. That means on the network card, which is connected to the cable, okay? Not on the wireless, all right? And I will tell you in a moment why we are putting this IP address. So let's follow the lab and then we know why we are doing this work. So I will go here to the network interface card. We go to network and sharing center and then to the adapter. So this is the interface. And then I will go here inside of it to TCP IP version 4. And yeah, I have the IP already set, which is 192.168.2.1 with a subnet mask 255.255.255.0. Okay, so this is the first step we need to do. You can put 192.168.2.2 or .3 or .4 or any range of the IP, but not 2.66, because in a moment I will tell you why you don't have to put 2.66. And if you want to check that we have set the right IP address, so we can go here and say IP config and then enter, we can see that the Ethernet adapter interface has received an IP 192.168.2.1, and that's the IP address that we have set it on the interface. Point one is done. Point number two, connect Ethernet 1 of NFT to AC to the PoE interface on the PoE adapter. And then point number three, connect your PC to the LAN interface on the PoE adapter. So what does it mean? When you buy the NFT, in my case, I'm using for this course NFT to AC. So when you buy the Infinity device or the NFT device, it mainly comes with the following settings. So you can see this is the NFT. When you buy it, it comes the NFT device, but also it comes with it a PoE adapter. And this PoE adapter has a power cord and then it's connected to the power. Okay, so here is the power. Okay, so what you need to do, you have to make the cables connected this way in order to be able to have access to the NFT device. So in this case, you need to put a cable between, you have here an Ethernet plus PoE in port. Okay, so this is the port here. You have to put a cable, which is a UTP cable, to the PoE interface, which is on the adapter. Why? In order to have this device powered on. So if you don't do that, it will not be powered on. You need to have the device powered on, otherwise you cannot make configuration on it. And then you need to put another cable from the LAN here interface to the network card interface that you have just set an IP on it, which is 192.168.2.1. Okay, so this is the settings. And in this case, your router and your PC will be on the same network. Okay, so you have to consider that this LAN port here is a LAN port on the router. Okay, so that means you are connected your PC to the router directly. So this is what is asking here and the 2 points. You can see here, connect Ethernet 1 of NFT to AC to the PoE interface on the PoE adapter. Okay, so we have connected now Ethernet 1, so this one here, to the PoE interface. And then on point number two, they're asking to connect your PC to the LAN interface of the PoE adapter. So also we connect our PC to this LAN interface, which is on the adapter. In this way, the router is powered on, and also our computer is connected to the router to the same network. So this is the settings that you have to do. I have already done that, but I just wanted to show you that you need to do this in order to have communication and connectivity between your PC and your router. Point number two is done, and point number three is done. Now we have to ping from the PC to 192.168.2.66, and we have to check if we have reply and what do we conclude. So if we go back here to the graph, we have set on the computer an IP address of 192.168.2.1. Yeah, so this is the IP address that we have set on the computer. Now they are saying that you need to ping to 192.168.2.66 and check if we have a reply. So let's do that. I will open the command prompt here and I will say ping 192.168.2.66, and then I'll say enter, and then you can see I have a reply, and you can see the time is 1 millisecond. That means it is in my network. So what do we conclude here? This is very important to remember, that we conclude that the router by default has an IP address of 192.168.2.66/24. Okay, and that's why the reason I told you that you don't put on your computer this IP, which is 192.168.2.66. Otherwise, you have a conflict with the router. You can put any IP from this range and leave 2.66 not on your computer in order to have communication between your PC and your router. Okay, so very important, remember the default IP address on all NFT devices that we have from LegalWave is 192.168.2.66. And in this case, if I want now to open a browser, so if I go to the browser here and I write 192.168.2.66, and I have now a web communication between my computer and the router, and you can see I'm inside now the NFT device. We don't need now to start doing the configuration, but just remember, this is very important, that by default, the IP address on the NFT device, any type of NFTs that we have, it is 192.168.2.66. Actually, it is called the DHCP fallback IP address, because by default, the NFT devices, all they have DHCP enabled. That means that if you have your router connected to the internet, then the ISP give you an IP address to this router, then it will take the IP address which is received from the DHCP from the ISP. But in case there is no DHCP on the network, that in our case you can see that the router is not connected to anything, then it will go to something we call DHCP fallback, and the IP address is for the DHCP fallback 192.168.2.66. We have done point number 4, and we have concluded that the DHCP fallback IP address, it is 192.168.2.66, and that's the IP address needed to be able to enter to the router in order to make the configuration. So this is what I wanted to show you in this lab. It was very short, but it is a very important lab, so we know how we can connect to the router and to be able to make the configuration. I hope that this lab was informative for you, and I will see you in the upcoming lecture.